Good morning. A warm welcome to all those who are joining us on this fourth Sunday in Advent for our service of readings and music for Christmas, arranged by our organist and choirmaster, Ian Laurie. Our thanks to Ian and to all those who have contributed. Later today at 4 o'clock, there will be a celebration of Christingle led by our Minister Clare on Zoom, for which you should already have received the direct link. At 5:30, you're invited to join in the National Online Carols on the Doorstep service, and details of this and of all our Christmas services can be found in the December newsletter. On Christmas Day, there will be a Zoom service led by our minister starting at 10:30 a.m. The next podcast service will be on the 27th of December, led by our minister. Thank you.
We come to worship God on this, our special service of carols and readings. So on this fourth week of Advent, the new candle is for the Blessed Virgin Mary, for the acceptance of God's will and the promise of the coming Christ. We light this candle for the Lord who seeks to work in us and through us. We also light it for all who have changed the world through their dedication and self-sacrifice.
When we wait upon the Holy Spirit,
the Lord comes as he came to the Blessed Virgin Mary.
When we trust in our God and commit ourselves to him,
the Lord comes as he came to the Blessed Virgin Mary.
When we say to God, "Your will be done,"
the Lord comes as he came to the Blessed Virgin Mary.
When we say yes to the call of God,
the Lord comes as he came to the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Rest in his presence and be aware of his love. Let his presence be a light in your darkness,
a candle in the dark.
The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. To you be praise and glory for ever. In the darkness of this passing age, your light has shone out. You have not forced yourself upon us, but you come if we so will it. As we rejoice in the obedience of the Blessed Virgin, may we accept you into our lives and homes, knowing that you have come to dwell among us. Blessed be God for ever.
Amen.
We come to sing our first carol, one of praise, of the Father's love begotten, ere the worlds began to be. After this, the rest of the service will proceed unannounced. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Genesis, chapter 3, verses 8 to 13 and 22 and 23. That evening they heard the Lord God walking in the garden, and they hid from him among the trees. But the Lord God called out to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden. I was afraid and hid from you because I was naked." "Who told you that you were naked?" God asked. "Did you eat the fruit that I told you not to eat?" The man answered, "The woman you put here with me gave me the fruit, and I ate it." The Lord God asked the woman, "Why did you do this?" She replied, "The snake tricked me into eating it." Then the Lord God said, "Now the man has become like one of us and has knowledge of what is good and what is bad. He must not be allowed to eat fruit from the tree of life and live forever." So the Lord God sent him out of the Garden of Eden and made him cultivate the soil from which he had been formed. Thanks be to God.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time forth and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. A reflection, a poem by M.S. Lowndes, The True Meaning of Christmas. Jesus Christ was born this day, so many years before. He came a servant to the lost, though he was Lord of Lords. We celebrate this joyous time, reflecting on his birth. Not born in a mansion, but a stable, as if he had no worth. He came so he could identify with the human heart of man, and gave his life as a sacrifice, offering a better plan. A plan that reconciles us back to our loving Father God, bringing hope and redemption from sin's ruling iron rod. For this is the only reason that we should celebrate this day. To become focused on anything else would take the meaning away. So let's arise with joy in our hearts and share it with everyone. The meaning of Christmas will always be the birth of Jesus, God's Son.
Thank you. you, Bethlehem in Ephrathah, small as you are among Judah's clans, out of you shall come forth a governor for Israel, one whose roots are far back in the past in days gone by. Therefore, only as long as a woman is in labour shall he give up Israel, and then those that survive of his race shall rejoin their brethren. He shall appear to be the shepherd in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they shall continue, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth, and he shall be a man of peace.
Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth. He had a message for a young woman promised in marriage to a man named Joseph, who was a descendant of King David. Her name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Peace be with you. The Lord is with you and has greatly blessed you." Mary was deeply troubled by the angel's message, and she wondered what his words meant. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God has been gracious to you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king, as his ancestor David was, and he will be the king of the descendants of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." Mary said to the angel, "I am a virgin. How then can this be?" The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and God's power will rest upon you. For this reason, the Holy Child will be called the Son of God. Remember your relative Elizabeth. It is said that she cannot have children, but she herself is now 6 months pregnant, even though she is very old. For there is nothing that God cannot do. I am the Lord's servant, said Mary. May it happen to me as you have said. And the angel left her.
Chapter 2. The Birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. There can be few years when you have not heard the story of the birth of Jesus through Luke's simple words. In her poem, The Story of Christmas, Doreen paints a picture of the Nativity, but also relates a little of what it means for us all. The Story of Christmas by Doreen Sowden. There is no story as wondrous and haunting, as sweet on the senses, as glorious and true, as the wonderful story, the story of Jesus, the child in the manger, both ancient and new. The long-ago version, a God-gifted maiden picked out of the masses to mother a child who would grow to be saviour of millions, though born as a baby, all gentle and mild. The child in the manger, the animals round him, was worshipped by shepherds, by angels and kings, adored by his mother, knew God as his father, and knew all the pain that humanity brings. From snow scenes with oxen, from stable to city, from time immemorial up to today, the story of Jesus, the child in the manger, is told to our children to teach them to pray. The story of Christmas, a star and a searching, a mother, a baby, a stable, a stall, a choir of angels, and loving and giving, all make up the loveliest story of all.
Thank you. in this same district there were shepherds out in the fields, keeping watch through the night over their flock, when suddenly there stood before them an angel of the Lord, and the splendour of the Lord shone round them. They were terror-stricken, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid. I have good news for you. There is great joy coming to the whole people. Today, in the city of David, a deliverer has been born to you, the Messiah, the Lord. And this is your sign. You will find a baby lying wrapped in his swaddling clothes in a manger." All at once there was with the angel a great company of the heavenly host, singing the praises of God. "Glory to God in highest heaven, and on earth his peace for men on whom his favour rests." And now a short poem entitled "The Work of Christmas." When the song of the angel is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and the princes are home, the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among people.
When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying which had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. Elizabeth Barrett Browning pictures the scene. The cold, the stable, the miracle of the newborn babe. The humility linking the shepherds and the kings. This is her poem, The Holy Night. We sat among the stalls at Bethlehem. The dumb kine, from their fodder turning them, softened their horned faces to almost human gazes toward the newly born. The simple shepherds from the starlit brooks brought visionary looks, for still in their astonished hearing rung the strange sweet angel tongue. The magi of the east, in sandals worn, knelt reverent, sweeping round with long pale beards, their gifts upon the ground. The incense, myrrh and gold, these baby hands were impotent to hold. So let all earthlies and celestials wait upon thy royal state. Sleep, sleep, my kingly one.
Thank you. St. John tells how the Word became flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness, to bear witness about the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness about the light. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. That uniquely wonderful insight from John, the disciple whom Jesus loved, was written about 50 years after our Lord Christ's death and resurrection. Some 19 centuries later, into our own days, another John, the poet John Betjeman, was inspired to write. And is it true? And is it true, this most tremendous tale of all, seen in a stained glass window's hue, a baby in an ox's stall, the maker of the stars and sea become a child on earth for me? And is it true? For if it is, no loving fingers tying strings around those tissued fripperies, the sweet and silly Christmas things, bath salts and inexpensive scent and hideous ties so kindly meant, no love that in a family dwells, no caroling in frosty air, nor all the steeple-shaking bells can with this single truth compare, that God was man in Palestine and lives today in bread and wine.
Thank you. have chosen a prayer poem by Helen Steiner Rice called A Christmas Gift of Love, which was printed in one of many volumes published after her death, with this particular collection called Daily Reflections. My book was published in 1994 by Premier Books London, but Helen was an American writer who died in 1981. Miracles are marvels that defy all explanation. And Christmas is a miracle and not just a celebration. For when the true significance of this so-called Christmas story penetrates the minds of men and transforms them with its glory, then only can rebellious man, so hate-torn with dissension, behold his adversaries with a broader, new dimension. For we can only live in peace when we learn to love each other and accept all human beings with the compassion of a brother. And it takes the Christ of Christmas to change man's point of view, for only through the Christ child can all men be born anew. And that is why God sent his Son as a Christmas gift of love, so that wickedness and hatred, which the world had so much of, could find another outlet by following in Christ's way and discovering a new power that violence can't outweigh. And in the Christmas story of the Holy Christ Child's birth is the answer to a better world and goodwill and peace on earth. Let us pray. Wherever we are today, listening to the prophecies and stories from so long ago, we can join alongside the people who heard the words from God for the first time. The miracle of faith was as old and as new for them as it is for us. We marvel that we commemorate events from over 2,000 years ago and before. Praise be to you, Father. Peace on earth and goodwill to all men. This is an age-old cry that comes from our hearts, Lord. Today we pray in sadness once more for peace to come to our war-torn world. We remember with bowed heads the people of Afghanistan, Syria, and Yemen. We think of Pakistan and Palestine and many African countries where there is so much unrest and upheaval. Remove from our hearts, Father, the hatred, the greed, the envy and the suspicion which has driven man from the beginning to today to go to war. May the love brought down at Christmas rule in our hearts, we pray. We are all fighting a new battle, Father, struggling to find ways to combat an unseen enemy, the virus that has meant that we have had to keep away from people as much as possible since March. We have had to decide for ourselves just what this has meant for us as individuals and families. This Christmas, there will be many people who are alone. We pray for them. And there will be many people who have decided that they are going to see family and friends out with current guidelines, no matter the possible consequences. We pray for them also. We thank and pray for all the people who have helped us these past months and those who are helping us to celebrate our Christmas this coming week. May we too be part of the answer to a better world and be bringers of goodwill and peace in the new year. Bless the sick and the grieving, Lord. We ask for healing, if that is your will, for the sick, and for comfort and courage for the bereft. Bless those who will try to sleep tonight, despite their hunger and fear, not only in some far-off country, but here in our country, here in Leeds. At this time, Lord, we need to look forward. We give thanks that there is more than the hope of a vaccine now. People are being vaccinated. We pray for improved worldwide economic prospects. We pray for improved political relationships. And we pray that one day soon, this congregation, our church family, will worship together in our, in your church building. We ask all of these things in your name, God of hope, God of love, God our Saviour.
Amen.
Let us join together in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Unable to join us on Zoom for the Christingle service this afternoon or on Christmas morning, I wish you a blessed Christmas, and may the joy and peace of the Christmas message fill your heart and your home, and may the light and hope of Christ be with you always.
Amen.